Okay, today we're going to solve or answer. I prefer in the sign answer for solve. Solve linear equations. This is a review compared to other vlogs I've posted at this point, but we're going to talk about how to approach this and what we do. We're going to focus on one variable for this vlog, but there are subsequent vlogs where we work with two variables and solve two for two variables at the same time. And we'll see how to approach that later. Okay, remember, when we say solve, and we have one variable, so we have 4x minus 11 equals 33. I expect one answer to match just one variable. There aren't many solutions here, just one solution. What we want to do is isolate x on one side of the equal sign, have nothing else with it. We need to see what's with x right now, and what's really blocking our way from having x isolated. We have negative 11, so we want to undo negative 11, 4x minus 11. The opposite would be to add 11. When we do that, we'll get 0, but we need to do it on both sides, left and right, to maintain balance in our equation. Well, okay, now we've gotten rid of the negative 11. Now we have 4x equals 44. Now, the relationship between 4 and x is 4 times x. Now, multiplication, the inverse of that, or the opposite for this point, would be division. So if we divide 4x by 4, we will be undoing the 4 times x. Now, remember, we have to work on both the left side and the right side to maintain balance. So now we have an answer. X equals 11. I believe I'm right, but how can we know? What we do, we have to check our answers to make sure we haven't made any mistakes. I apologize. Not check both sides. I mean, we have to check to see if x equals 11, and when it's replaced in the original equation, do we get 33 equals 33? Okay, x equals 11. Oh yeah. 33. Let me hold up a minute. Now, within the check or checking our equations, you have to go back to the original equation. You can't use any of your subsequent work. For example, 4x equals 44. Divide by 4, it's 11. I'm right. No, you can't do that. You could still be mistaken. You have to go back to your original equation and substitute your answer in for the variable. So now I can you can see that and say, oh, it's done. 33 equals 33. 44 minus 11, everybody knows it's 33. You must prove it. Your job is to prove your answer is correct and follow it through to the very end. Now, our check does work out. And what does that really mean, though? This true, this T, the true. Does that mean 33 is the answer? No. It means when x is equal to 11, the answer, we substitute in the equation, the two sides, left and right, are equal. It's a true statement. So our answer gives us a true value for our equation. Any equation, left and right side have to be equal to be true. Okay, here we have it. When you have an equation with a variable, the variable means we don't know what the value is. X can be anything. Once we replace x with 11, we need to figure out if that equation is true. Without the number there, there's no truth value. But there is one answer that if we replace it where x is, the equation is true. So 4 times 11 minus 11 is 33. That's a true statement. Now, go on and talk about what if I were to find the wrong answer or I solved it incorrectly. So now, we already know 4x minus 11 equals 44. If we were to put in 9, it wouldn't be correct. Now, what if we were, let's show what it looks, let's see what it looks like if it's wrong. So we can see here that 25 does not equal 44. So when x equals 9, if we were to substitute in this equation, the truth value would be false. So x equals 9, it means that this equation here, 4x minus 11 equals 44, is false. So 9 is not the solution. Now, this principle works for all equations. If you have a variable, replace the variable with the number you found. As you check it, when the two sides are equal, it's true. If you find an answer, or I believe it's the answer, and you replace it with the variable to the variable, and you work down and it's false. What that means is my answer is incorrect, or my check was done improperly. But either way, I have to go back and check my work. Thanks for paying attention, and I'll see you next time.